Isaiah 53. We start reading from verse 1. The prophet said, as led by the Spirit, who has believed or trusted in, relied upon, and clung to our message of that which was revealed to us, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been disclosed? For the servant of God grew up before him like a tender plant, and like a root out of a dry ground. He has no form or comeliness, royal kingly pomp, that we should look at him, and no beauty that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected, and forsaken by men, a man of sorrow and pains, and acquainted with grief and sickness, and like one from whom men hide their faces. He was despised, and we did not appreciate his worth, or have any esteem for him. Surely he has borne our griefs. He has borne our griefs. He has carried our sicknesses, our weaknesses, our distresses, and carried our sorrows and pain of punishment. Yet we ignorantly considered him stricken, smitten, afflicted by God, as if with leprosy. But he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our guilt, and the iniquities, the chastisement needful to be obtained, peace and well-being for us was upon him, and with his stripes that wounded him, we are healed and made whole. Hallelujah. Today, I want us to take this verse scripture to scripture, and we're going to pray with Isaiah 53. The Bible says he was despised and rejected and forsaken by men, a man of sorrow and pain. Now we're going to be dealing with the spirit of rejection. We're going to be dealing with the spirit of sorrow. We're going to be dealing with the spirit of pain. We're going to be dealing with the spirit of grief. We're also going to be dealing with the spirit of sicknesses, because all these things, Jesus took it upon him. Hallelujah. Jesus took it upon him. We'll be dealing with all these things today as we begin to pray. And we're going to reject and rebuke Satan that has taken hold of people, people that are despised, people that are feeling rejected, people that are forsaken by men, people that are in deep sorrow, the many that are in pain, the many that are grieving at this hour, the many that are feeling weak, and they are carrying distresses, oppressed by Satan. Hallelujah. We're going to be asking God this day, by the power of the Holy Spirit within us, that let all these things in the life of the people be broken. And also we're going to release and realize that rejection goes together with the lack of love. And realize that most people that feel rejected, they don't feel loved. They always want to be appreciated, accepted. Sometimes they do things in very strange way because they're already rejected. Hallelujah. There is a spirit. This is why Jesus died. He took it on him. And the Bible says, surely he has borne our griefs, sicknesses, weaknesses, and distresses, and carried our soul and pain of punishment. Yet we ignorantly considered him stricken. Today we want to pray that let every ignorance leave the eyes of the people. That after today they will no more be ignorant. We consider him stricken and smitten, afflicted by God. But he was wounded for our transgression. Today we're going to bind the power of sin that is taking hold of people. So we'll be praying all these scriptures. The power of sin. Because the Bible says he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our guilt. Today we're going to take under arrest the spirit of guilt. Last time Sunday, I was telling you the person that brings people into guilt is the devil himself. Hallelujah. He pushed you to do stuff. When you join him, he started accusing you. and the spirit of iniquity and chastisement. The Bible says needful to obtain peace, well-being for us. And we want to speak the peace of God into situations that have been hopeless, because that is what we are believing this day. When you are sick, the problem is not even a sickness. Isaiah 53, and Jesus accomplished all every one of these assignments. Hallelujah. So today we're going to pray with this. We're going to agree with this. We're going to start with verse 3. And every one of these things that are called, we're going to deal with it. So we're not going to pass any of them. There are people that are feeling despised. The reason why Jesus said go into the highway and the byway and all those people to come. You should understand that Jesus already first of all sent some group of people to go call a particular group of people. Those people were the people that were recognized. They were recognized in the society. Those are the people that people know of. Those are the people that were known. The rich, the famous. So, when they refused to come, what did he do? He said, for the despised, the rejected, the ones that were sorrowful, the ones that were in pain, the ones that were going through distresses, the ones that did not even have food to eat, he sent them. He sent his disciples to bring those people in so that he will heal them, he will feed them, they will receive a miracle, they will be filled with joy. Hallelujah. So we're just going to agree with Jesus, his mandate on earth that he has given to us this day, even as we begin to pray. Somebody just lift up your hands to him. Say, Father, we thank you.
Father, we thank you.
We give you all the praise.
We give you all the praise.
And the glory.
And the glory.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Your word declares,
the word declares,
and this is the confidence,
this is the confidence
that
we have
in him,
in him.
That if we ask anything,
that if we ask anything
in accordance to his will,
in accordance to his will,
he heareth us.
Father,
we are standing on the finished works of Christ. Jesus came to finish the work. He came,
to
do your will, and to finish the work.
And to finish the
on the cross,
he said it's finished.
That's why today we stand at the gate of the enemy in the name of Jesus, by divine virtue, authority,
power invested
upon us
over
all power
of the enemy.
We bring under arrest
spirit of rejection.
Spirit of unforgiveness. We bring under arrest. Spirit of grief. We bring under arrest. Spirit of affliction. We bring under arrest.
This spirit
that has been destabilizing
the mind
and the hearts,
of men.
Of men and women, and in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus, we rebuke Satan,
we
bind him
over their lives,
we rebuke him out of their mind, we rebuke him out of their spirit, and we set love in motion, we set healing in motion, we set acceptance in motion in the place of pain. We lose joy, emotion, in the name of Jesus. Every mental distress and disorder, in the name of Jesus, we bind that spirit. We bind that spirit that have been tormenting the mind and the spirit of people. We declare Satan, take your hands off their mind, off their spirit, right now, in the name of Jesus. Say in the name of Jesus. Say in
the name of Jesus.
We loose.
We loose.
We set loose.
We set loose.
Emotion.
Emotion.
The spirit of soundness of mind. Every mental disorder. We arrest that spirit. And we release soundness of mind. In the name of Jesus.
Stop your lips. We're going to bring every disease into captivity. Every spirit that is responsible for sicknesses. Jesus received all those stripes that people will be healed. And he did not only do that, he received all those stripes. He went through everything he went through that we may receive our miracles. Today we are about to ask God to rain miracles.
I'm believing God for many things to happen. That woman that wasn't fruitful, that she'll be fruitful.
Amen. Yes.
I'm believing God for many things to happen.
Amen. Yes.
Very many, many things. And I want you to know something. It's not going to take Jean-Pierre to do this. It's going to take God himself. Yes. My hope and my trust is in him.
Yes.
I so much rely on him that he will do what he has to do. So just lift up your hands with me. Even as we start releasing all these people, begin to release people's healings. We begin to release love. We begin to release divine help. We are placing a demand. We are taking those things in the mighty name of Jesus. If the Bible call it bread, if the Bible say healing is the children's bread, and the Bible talk about the crumbs on the ground, then that means that all of these things, and they are given to us as food to nourish our bodies. To nourish our bodies when we feel terrible. So we're going to release things.
Hallelujah.
That people will begin to take them right now. And Jesus did not only come for that, he came also for salvation. The highest form of healing is salvation. The highest form of healing is salvation. The highest form of healing is salvation. Because it heals your mind, it heals your body, then you become born again. You receive everything at once. That's why John said, I pray that your whole spirit, soul, and body, that you prosper in these three things. Hallelujah. And that one only comes by the spirit of salvation. So lift up your hands. Say, Father.
Father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
In the place of weaknesses.
In the place of weaknesses.
That have attacked.
The
lives
of your children.
The life
of the man
in the world
that has caused them
to be unable
to resist
satanic
lies
in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. By the power of the Holy Ghost, every defense wall of Satan in their life, in the name of Jesus, we command that wall. Let it break. 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 In the name of Jesus. Say,
Father,
we bring on that rest.
We bring on that rest.
Every spirit
that
has been responsible to cause the people.
To cause the people.
To be distressed,
to be distressed
in their mind,
in
their spirit,
in
the name of Jesus,
we
bind that spirit, we rebuke Satan,
we
turn them loose by the power of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus.
So we take, we bring under arrest
the power of sin.
The power of sin.
That is so much,
that is so much
entangled,
entangled
in the will,
in the will,
and the minds,
and the minds
of people,
of people.
The power of sin,
the power of sin,
the power of sin,
the power of sin.
Say, Jesus,
Jesus
was wounded for our transgression.
For our transgression.
We declare to you, Satan,
by
divine authority
of the blood of
Jesus, you have no right.
You have no right.
You have no right.
You are a liar.
We command you, take your hands of their will,
of
their minds, right now, we lose salvation,
we
bind sin, in the name of Jesus.